What did it feel like to kill off your first zombie in your very first feature film as well?
It was amazing. We actually had a kill list on our camera where we ticked off every time we killed a zombie. 3 days into the shoot, we got so tired and it didn't have any space left on the camera, so we stopped doing it. But it was a lot of fun. And what I love about zombie movies is that zombies are just so much fun. You love them because they want to eat you, and why they want to do things to you. They're kind of a little bit helpless, and they shuffle around and in pain, and you kind of identify with them. At the same time, you don't feel bad if someone just alleviates their pain and kills them. So that's what I love about zombie films.
Now, you mentioned that the kind of pace that they move at, and you're kind of going with a traditional zombie slow pace in this movie, aren't you? And there's a fantastic scene that you've got with a zombie chasing, as they can, Richard Briers, who's powering a Zimmer frame. Now, I can imagine that was going to be a really difficult scene to keep a straight face on.
Very much. I mean, when I set out to make the movie, I really wanted to make sure that there's lots of moments in there that you've never seen before in a zombie movie. Key to that was the concept that while the zombies are slow, the pensioners are slower. And we wrote the scene of the slow motion Zimmer frame chase to encapsulate that idea. And of course, it came to life with Richard Briers and a fantastic zombie behind him. And it just sort of was so much better than I imagined it. And I was giggling, of course, when I saw it. And it's an amazing scene to sort of edit and put together and be in an audience with to see. So
you've got, as well as great actors in the film, you've got very kind of British, very East End music as well, haven't you? You've got Chaz and Dave in there. How did that happen?
Well, I was really keen to include Chaz and Dave in the soundtrack at least, and luckily they said yes, and they composed an original track for us called Head to Head with the Undead, which is coming out as a single as well. And we put it in our closing credits to just sort of round off the movie and, you know, pay homage to all the great East End culture that we're referencing. And to be honest, Cockneys vs. Zombies is my love declaration to the East End. I've lived there for 15 years and I just wanted it to be really warm, loving, kind of homage to everything that's great in East London.
Why do you think Cockneys would be so fantastically kick-ass against zombies?
The thing about Cockneys is that over the last century, they've fought off everyone and everything that wanted to invade their turf, whether that's the Zulus or the Old Bill or whoever else dared to put a foot into East London. But they've never fought zombies. So I felt this was the battle to finish off the great chapter of Cockney culture and take it to the next level.
What kind of influences did you have in the film in terms of horror and zombie? Are there horror and zombie films that you love?
Well, I grew up watching films like Brain Dead or Evil Dead 2 on VHS tapes when my parents had gone to bed and they didn't know I was watching it. And I love the sort of anarchic, funny humor in those films. And that's kind of was the main inspiration behind the movie, bringing back some of that sort of fun, gung-ho, action-packed zombie action.
And the Cockneys you've got in the film, you've got people like Alan Ford, as you said, you've got Richard Briers, Pussy Galore, former Bond girl, Honor Blackman, Dudley Sutton, loads of fantastic people, and that's just the more mature actors. Now, they're quite vocal, they're not shy of giving their opinion, are they, in the film to each other, they're very forthright. How were they on set? Did they pay attention to you as a director enough?
No, all the cast were amazing, and I was so blessed to get such a good bunch of actors together, from really interesting character actors, legends, to comedic actors, and I was really blessed that they all said yes and wanted to work with me, and it was a great atmosphere on set. Some of the older cast came up to me and said, "Matthias, we have not worked together since 1962 and I was like, "Oh my god, I wasn't even close to being born at that time." So they all were just so excited to come together and work together and brought 50 years of experience or more to the screen, and it was a real kind of great fun experience.
What have you learned most from this experience that you'll take on to hopefully your next feature and the one after that?
Well, Cockneys was like a big budget movie but done on a humble British budget. Every day was a huge logistical 10 actors, 50 zombies, action sequences. It was a logistical kind of tough thing to pull off, and we got it done and it was great. And I love that sort of big epic filmmaking, and I hope that this primed me for the next step in that direction. I'm developing a great science fiction project in LA and a fantasy movie over here, and fingers crossed one of those will happen next.
Well, lots of luck with that. Cockneys versus Zombies is a great first film, and lots of luck with the other ones too.